Hey everyone, welcome back to Zimist Coded. It's been 2 weeks since my last video, and I've missed you all. Today, I'm excited to show you how to easily generate and properly format complex math equations from ChatGPT into Microsoft Word. Now, you might wonder why this is important. Math equations can be tricky to format correctly in Word, especially when copying directly from ChatGPT. I'll guide you through the steps to ensure your equations look professional and are formatted the right way. Before we jump in, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow and reach more people who can benefit from these tutorials. So let's get started by opening our browser and heading over to chatgpt.com. We'll ask ChatGPT to generate a complex math equation for us. Now that ChatGPT has created our equation, we'll copy it into Microsoft Word. But here's the thing. When you paste it directly, the equation won't format properly. Let's go ahead and paste it as is to see what happens. As you can see, the equation doesn't look right. Even if we copy all the text from ChatGPT, it still doesn't work. So, what's the right way to do this? We need to ask ChatGPT to convert the equation into LaTeX format. LaTeX is compatible with MS Word and will ensure proper formatting. Let's ask ChatGPT to give us the LaTeX version of our equation. And there it is, the equation in LaTeX format. Next, we'll copy the LaTeX code and paste it into our Word document. Now, highlight the text and press Alt and Equals on your keyboard. You'll see that this converts the selection into a proper equation. Under the Conversions tab, make sure LaTeX is selected. Then, under Convert Math Regions, you can choose Current Professional to apply the conversion to the selected equation, or All Professional to apply it to every LaTeX equation in the document. For now, let's select Current Professional. And there you have it. We've successfully converted a complex math equation from ChatGPT into a readable and properly formatted equation in MS Word. That's it for today's tutorial. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Zimist Coded. See you in the next one.